first one is the body plan and other one is the coelom. In the previous session, we have seen about the habitat of the species, levels of organization and the symmetry. But today in this class, we are going to see about the body plan. So body plans is such a thing that how does the body of the species have been arranged. So how does the species body is arranged? So the arrangement patterns, which we call it as body plan. So body plan is categorized into three different types. First one is cell aggregate body plan. So here we have seen the example. This is nothing but the cellular level of organization. So here the cells are loosely aggregated and each cell has its own role and responsibilities. So each and every cell has its own roles and responsibilities. So example, so we can take the example of cell aggregate body plan. For the cell aggregate body plan, we can take the example of sponges. Okay, so the second case, we can take blind sac body plan. So in blind sac body plan, here we can say that there is the presence of incomplete gut. Okay, so there is the presence of incomplete gut. So what do you mean by the term incomplete gut? See, the digestive system is not very well developed, right? The digestive system is not very well developed. So if you are taking the species, of Hydra, here you can see one cavity. So this cavity acts as a site for both ingestion and egestion of the food substances. Okay, so one cavity, it acts as the site of ingestion as well as the site of egestion. So incomplete gut, the species which do not have the complete gut, they are called as the blind sac body plan. And here we can see only one cavity which acts as a site for both ingestion as well as the egestion of the waste materials. And third one, tube within tube. So example for this blind sac body plan, we can take example as Hydra, right? Then the third one is tube within tube. Body plan. So if you are taking about the tube within the tube body plan, here what happens? We can see the complete gut. So here we can see the complete gut in case of the tube within tube body plan. Right. So here you have to be clear with a term that, so during the formation of the alimentary canal, so what happens here initially, during the formation of the alimentary canal, first what happens, the zygote, they develop to form an embryo. Okay, later the embryo develops into a stage called as morula. Okay, it develops into a stage called as morula. From morula, it forms the morula. Later, during the course of development, they are arranged in a particular fashion and they form a cavity. Okay, the cavity which is being formed in the next stage of morula, we call it as the blastocoele. Okay, so during the course development of this blastocoele, further develops into blastopore. Pore is nothing but the small cavity. So this is called as the blastopore. Right. So if this blastopore is formed in the anterior part, and slowly that blastopore, it develops to form the complete alimentary canal. The blastopore, later it develops into the complete alimentary canal. So coming to this blastopore, the blastopore, it has two conditions. Okay, so if the development of the blastopore has two conditions. First condition is that if the blastopore first develops into mouth. Okay, the blastopore first develops into mouth and the blastopore first develops into anus. Right, the species which are during the course development, if the blastopore give rise to the mouth in the initial stage and later the development of anus, we call it as protozoans. Right? So if the blastopore develops into anus first and later the formation of mouth happens, this we can say, tell it as deuterostomes. Right? So this is about the body plan. So body plan consists of three conditions. What is that? Cell aggregate body plans and blind sac body plan, tube within tube body plan, protostomes and deuterostomes, right? So for this, all the higher organisms, okay, all the higher organisms may come under this tube within tube body plan, right? So the next concept we are going to see about the species of the kingdom Animalia is the coelom. Coelom is nothing but the fluid filled body cavity. Fluid filled body cavity. Okay, so coelom is nothing but the fluid filled body cavity. So coming to the coelom, coelom is again of many types. The first type is called as acoelomates. So acoelomates, I have defined the coelom as fluid filled body cavity. Now, if I introduce A before the coelom, it implies there is the absence of coelom, absence of fluid filled body cavity, right? So, what is that? Here, if you're drawing the diagram, what is present? Outer ectoderm is present, inner endoderm is present, and the middle mesoderm is not present, and it is packed with the tuft of parenchymatous cells. Okay, it is packed with the tuft of the parenchymatous cells. So such species, we can tell it as acoelomates, and we can take the example of flatworms. Okay, so we can take the example of flatworms. And coming to the second condition, so coming to the second type of the coelom, we can take pseudocoelomata. Pseudocoelom. Pseudo, amoeba moves with the help of pseudopodia. Pseudo means what? False. So false feet, amoeba moves with the help of the false feet. So similarly, pseudocoelom means the cavity is present but it is not in the complete one. It is not very well developed. So if we are drawing the diagram, it is outer ectoderm, middle mesoderm, okay, so sorry, inner endoderm, and the mesodermal layer are scattered here and there, right? So the mesodermal layer is not completely formed. So such conditions is called as the pseudocoelomata, right? So here you can take the example of What is that? Roundworms. Okay, you can take the examples of roundworms, right? So coming to the next one is Eucoelomates. Eucoelomata are the species which have true coelom. So they have peritoneal layers. So they have, this is the alimentary canal, which is called as the endoderm. And this is called as the outer ectoderm. Here the peritoneal layers are present. So this is the parietal peritoneum. And this layer is the visceral peritoneum. So parietal peritoneum. And this is visceral peritoneum. Here we can also categorize this Eucoelomata into two types. First one is called as Schizoelom. Here the mesoderm is splitted into halves. Okay, the mesodermal layer is splitted in case of the Schizoelom, and the next one is Enterocoelom. So if we are talking about the Enterocoelom, it is becoming the patch of the Archenteron. Archenteron is nothing but the initial stage of the, it is the part of the digestive system in the initial stage. So the patch of the, it becomes the patch of the, what is that? Archenteron. So this is about the coelom. So coming, so this happens in all the Echinodermata as well as the chordate species. So coming once again, recollecting the points. So coming to the body plan, it is divided into three types. They are cell aggregate body plan, blind sac body plan, tube within tube body plan. So coming to coelom, it is Acoelomata, Pseudocoelomata, Eucoelomata. So Eucoelom is the true coelom. So true coelom is again divided into Schizoelom and Enterocoelom. So Schizoelom, here the mesodermal layer is splitted here. Okay. So coming to the Enterocoelom, you can go for the example of the Echinodermata and chordata. So here I can tell you another one type of coelom, which is called as Hemocoelom, where the true coelom is reduced to pseudocoelom. Okay, the true coelom is reduced to pseudocoelom. Here we can go with the example of Arthropoda and Mollusca. Right, it is the coelom cavity is filled with some blood. Okay, Hemocoelom means the cavity which is filled with blood. Right, so that type of coelom is called as the Hemocoelomata. Here the true coelom is reduced to pseudocoelom. Okay, so in this condition the true coelom is reduced to pseudocoelom, and we can go with the example of Arthropoda and we can go with the example of Mollusca. So in the upcoming classes we can see more about all the phylums which are present in the kingdom Animalia.